My name is Kyle Dunovan. I work with Timothy Verstein in the Coax lab at Carnegie Mellon. What I do in the lab is to build computational models of what we think the mechanism is behind these very simple movements, like when do you decide to move and when you decide not to move, what's really going on in your mind and in the brain. And so we try to use these computational models in combination with the neuroimaging sorts of methods to get at where those mechanisms are in the brain. It's really exciting because you can kind of be creative with these models, and you don't typically think of science or math as a creative sort of endeavor, but it's like building a model of anything else. If it doesn't, you know, fly or roll or whatever it is it's supposed to do, then you go back and you try to figure out what's wrong and then build it up again. It's a really fun process, even when you're wrong. And that's kind of the beauty of science, is that a lot of times you're wrong, but that gives you new insight into where to go to next. I'm from a small town in Nebraska. I didn't have the traditional trajectory. Both of my parents are physical therapists. I was extremely lucky to grow up in a family where it was encouraged to go against the grain, to keep looking for answers that satisfied me. I imagine that probably contributed quite a bit to my hunger for knowledge and what drove me into science. I was definitely not the straight-A student in junior high school growing up. And when you think about applying to graduate school or being successful after college, you often think about grades, about test scores, but it seems like the best defining quality for somebody who's going to be successful in science is that they're curious. If they're curious, they're going to keep exploring, and that's really what defines success in science, is being continuously motivated. When I was in college, I was taking a course called Limits of Consciousness, and the main topic of the course was the philosophy of mind and how the mind comes out of the brain, what happens to produce a subjective experience. And that was fascinating to me. These are things that philosophers have been arguing about for centuries, and it just occurred to me that the best way to get at the answers to those questions was to study the brain. I wanted to discover more and contribute to that knowledge that I was so passionate about. One of my favorite things about working in this lab is that everybody kind of has their own specialty, and you can ask your colleagues and your lab mates what they think about the problem.
C of T, which is your bias brain. C is the catch trial conditional.
And they always, approach it a little bit differently than how you're approaching it. And so sometimes we will just sit around and write equations on the board, and we'll argue with each other, and a lot of knowledge comes out of that. Science kind of captures this wanting to learn. And the cool thing about science and doing it directly is that you're not just learning from a textbook, you're able to discover new things yourself that eventually ends up in a textbook, but it's more exploratory. I think it's important for kids to know that even if they, are not the best student academically, that they can still be incredibly successful in science through working hard. But that hard work isn't that hard when you love what you do.